Well, welcome to the San Paolo Stadium here in the heart of Napoli, the home of the town's football team, but this week dominated by the best student athletes in the world. This morning, we will be concentrating mainly on the men's decathlon. Yesterday, we had a fairly interesting day for the leader, Sutisak Sinkton, who was the favourite coming in, but didn't exactly live up to that billing in some events. There is the lineup. So here we go then, day two is underway, and Kalshik is going well at the moment. Klusis is also there, but the man leading them at the moment on the inside is Brandoni. He's going to take it ahead of the Estonian Holtzman, with Atwell coming in behind him. So then confirmation then of Brandoni's win in 15.61 ahead of Holtzman, Atwell, De Brega, Kalshik, Klusik in that order. So then here is heat two. This time we do get the start, and Gong gets a flyer out of the blocks in his first at the first three hurdles. Still leading at the moment, being tracked down though on his outside by Pandiani. It's these two who are coming away. Gong is going to take this quite comfortably. Pandiani comes second, and Diamond takes third on the inside for Australia, which will certainly improve his chances.
So that's the times there. Pandiani of 15 seconds, Diamond in third with 15.07. And 15.22 for the Thai athlete, and Booth from New Zealand, 15.37. So we're getting ready for the men's decathlon discus. So the Australian comes in for his second throw. 49.32 is his personal best, and he achieved 45.92 on his first throw. So he'll be looking to get to 50 if he could. By far the best technician in the competition. Good at the back. Dropped his hand, so that's going to be around the same mark. You can see that red mark, that red line graphic, is the leader's throw, and that's his throw from the first round. Just seemed to fall off on the delivery phase. Slight improvement for the Australian, 46 metres now. Pandiani next in for his second throw. 34.76 on his first attempt. Got a best of 39 metres, 38. So he's capable of more in this competition. Good improvement though for him, 38.66 on his second attempt. And we move into the third and final attempt for these decathletes in the discus throw. So 39.49 is his best so far. Got a best of 43.43, so he would like desperately to get over 40 metres. Let's see if he can do it. Booth, New Zealand. Nice technique, good flight, good height. Yep, and he's over 40 metres. He'd be delighted with that. So Booth nails 41.65 on his final attempt.
So now the second attempt was successful. While Lane was disqualified from the false start. Less efforts in the race.
Sinkton, who leads the event overall. For his final attempt. And yes, he's over 40 metres, so saves the best till last. 42.01 for the Thai decathlete, and he'll be pleased with that attempt. So here we have the caption. You can see there, Diamond won the discus, highest distance, 46.52. Sinkton, 42.01 in second. Booth in third, 41.65. So, Sinkton. Well, there was a lot of clattering around of things, but the bar stayed on. Don't quite know how it's done that, and he gets the white flag. So first time clearance at 4 meters 10 for Singhal. The last remaining athlete in this men's decathlon from Group B. And look at that, he goes clear of 4:30 on his second attempt. Diamond, third and final attempt, 4 meters 60. Well, and he goes clear, that's what you call performing under pressure. So he needs that because that extends his lead over the Thai athlete. And this is Booth. Final attempt, 4 meters 80. Great clearance by Booth. Yes, it stayed up. So he's in the competition. He's got points in the bag. Okay, so here we go. There's a summary of the pole vault. Diamond, Booth, 480. The important one is sixth place is Singhon of Thailand, only clearing that height down there of 4 meters 10.
The men of the decathlon ready for the javelin, the ninth of the 10 events, as we take a look at the standings.
Aaron Booth, here he goes, second attempt, 54.45. Nice on the runway. Controls the point. Good shout. Now we have a javelin thrower amongst the team. And he goes 59.44. Now, not only is that an important throw for him, but Diamond, who goes last, who leads the current competition after the pole vault, is struggling. He's not a great javelin thrower. 40.56 in his first round. So unless he brings some magic to the arena here, he's improved slightly, but he's going to struggle to get over 50 metres. Now, that means that Booth could have a 9 to 10 metre lead over the Australian, and that will put Booth in first place going into the 1500. And I have to say, having seen them both run, I think Booth can start to think about taking gold here. 48.04 for the Aussie, and we go into the last round.
So then, this is the way that the men's decathlon looks after 9 of the 10 events, and the leader is Aaron Booth. Aaron Booth, who has had a couple of brilliant events in the pole vault and in the javelin. And now it looks as though it's going to be a pretty much a lap of honor for him in the 1500 meters. Well, 3 of the top 4 are on for a personal best. Singhon won't probably get it. He needs nearly 1,000 points to improve his 7,809 point personal best. However, Aaron Booth, very much within touching distance. 7,680 is his best. He's over 7,000 already going into this race. And it's Atwell that leads straight away.
Yeah, sorry to butt in there, Angus, but are they operating as a unit, the two Kiwis? Has Atwell sort of taken it out to help Booth, drag Booth around to the gold medal? He's looking at his watch, so he may have been set some splits here to help Booth ensure that he's going to win this event by a mile.
Booth, though, still comfortably in front of Gong. Gong in sixth place at the moment. And Booth, who was the bronze medalist 2 years ago, I think he's almost certain now to take the gold. Atwell, though, he's still hunting the bronze himself. However, he will have to go some. He's at some 300 points behind Singhon. And despite the slowness of Singhon in this 1500 metres, it probably won't be enough. Nevertheless, he might not have finished had it not been for a kindly official after the shot put, who was prepared to take a look at the replay and then change his mind.
No, official doing his official job, and it was in the discus, so...
Yes. Always good to get a bit of coaching.
Absolutely.
Well, Atwell is coming, and Booth is doing quite well, actually. He's not lost any more ground. Atwell putting on a little bit of a sprint now. 4:15 at the moment. He's going to be outside his personal best. It's been a grueling 2 days, though. Atwell's going to come across to win the 1,500 metres. Gong has come past Booth to take second place. And Booth will come across the line now and be crowned the World University Games decathlon champion. He crossed the line in around about 4:35. Garfield Marsden comes across as well for Britain. The Indian Vikas Kaushik, who has been a surprise in quite a few of the events, also comes lost. We knew absolutely nothing about the Indian before he came here. There was no information at all, so it's been quite a pleasant surprise to see how he's performed. Atwell then wins in 4:28.34, Gong in 4:30.74, and Boo was a little quicker actually than I said, 4:31.38, which is pretty good. That's only 3 seconds outside his personal best.
E quindi la terza posizione per il neozelandese Bolt, 4:31.38.
Now we'll see on the board the final results in the ring for.
However, the day will belong to Booth. And he did it by getting a personal best in the pole vault and then threw over 60 metres with the javelin. So then this is the result of the last race, Atwell taking it then. And it means that Aaron Booth is the decathlon World University Games champion with 7,827, a massive new personal best for the Kiwi.
Managed to clear 2:27 in the final chance. And
as we now look forward to the first individual final of the evening in the triple jump.
So Matheus Sá of Brazil lining up for his third jump in this men's triple jump final. He has a best so far of 15:48 on his first attempt. Had a no jump on his second round and needs at least 15:73. to get into the top eight, which is where they make the cut. So he's on the board. Oh, and that's a good jump from the Brazilian. So that'll be moving him into the top eight. He's got a best of 16:14, 16:21. So that puts him in silver medal position at the moment. The defending champion from 2017. He's jumped 17:18. That's his personal best from 2017. He's jumped 17:29 indoors. He is the defending champion. But he's had two no jumps, so this is it. He could be out if he has a no jump on this attempt. Well, he's on the board. Oh, and he sails past that red line that we can see on the graphic in the pit. And that is the leading jump so far. So two nose rows, you can see there, goes straight into the lead, 16:58. And we're coming into the last jump. So Milo of Brazil on the runway for his sixth and final attempt in the order that it is. He's reversed after the fifth round. Oh, he looks fast. There's a bow because he knows he's had a reasonable jump there. You know when you've had a reasonable contact with the floor. Look, look at this. Skips, jumps into the pit. 16:57 is currently led by Babayev of Azerbaijan, the defending champion, at 16:58. So he misses by 1 centimeter. So now we go to Matheus Sá of Brazil, 16:36, currently fourth. Two centimeters behind the Turk Özyurpek, who's on 16:38, but follows this jump. So what can the Brazilian do? Can he get into the medals? He needs 16:38 at least. Sixth and final attempt for the Brazilian. Sá. He's on the board. Oh! And if the red line indicates, then he has improved. We have to wait because it's closed. Let's have a look at this. Great pace on the run-up. Good kneeling. He's like a skimming stone, isn't he? He hits that hop, he stays up, keeps the hips high. Great jump into the pit. 16.57, he matches his compatriot Mello and goes into the silver medal position on countback. Özyurpak, the Turk, has one jump. He's been pushed out of the medals. 16.38, he needs 16.57 and more now to get into the medals. So final jump for Can Özyurpak. Can Özyurpak get in the medals? Oh, he has, I think. He has. He has. Has he got the white flag? Yes, he has. So, Milo, who went from sixth to second, has gone to third on countback. And Özyurpak, the Turk, has come out, and he may have gone into the lead with that jump. 16.56, oh my word. So, we have gold going to Babiev. The defending champion wins by 1 centimetre. To Matias Sarr of Brazil, 16.57. His compatriot, Alexandre Milo of Brazil, 16.57. But on countback, takes the bronze. And Özyurpak, who jumps 16.56 and finishes in fourth. What a conclusion to this event. And Babiev now can relax. He's got the gold by a centimetre. And he's a 17-meter man, so let's hope that he wants to get over 17 meters, because that would be the icing on the cake for this competition. Here he goes, final attempt. He's on the board, and he's gone large. Yeah, he's gone large at last. Babiev from Azerbaijan, who won it in 2017, takes it again. We knew that before the last attempt. We're waiting for that distance to come up. But that's how you do it. 16.89, so it's just short of 17 meters. And there we have confirmation of the men's triple jump. Babiev takes his second gold. Sarr, Brazil, 16.57 silver. He beat Milo on countback for the silver medal, and Milo takes the bronze. So the high jumpers are now being introduced.
In the sector to see who is the challenge. Result of the scoreboard. That was quite a good jump.
So next to jump will be Audrius Gleboskos of Lithuania. It'll be his second attempt at this height. And yes, he gets a good clearance. Puff of the cheeks. And he goes clear at that height on his second attempt. So this is going to be the Turkish athlete. This is Aiset of Turkey. Second attempt. And he goes clear, so he'll be going forward. So one failure and a clearance for Aiset. This is Dion Ivanov, who cleared 2.27 on his final attempt. Ivanov is continuing in the competition. It's put the bar up to 2.30 meters.
Allora, occhi puntati, pedana del salto in alto.
And he goes clear at 2.30. The Olympic finalist from 2016. Goes clear at 2.30. What a great clearance, and I think the reaction was one of relief.
Podio di Napoli 2019.
So we go to the infield, and we will be introducing the finalists in the women's javelin. She's ready to go. She's got a best of over 64 meters this year. Personal best 64.36 set in 2019. So she's quite capable. She has the tools. Let's see what she can do. Well, it's out closer to that 60-meter line. It's going to be an improvement for her. She's the best so far is 58.16, so it's going to be closer to 59 meters. 59.03 is bronze. So 59.16 for Kitaguchi. That does put her into second position currently. So this is the young lady from Lithuania who put the cat among the pigeons on the fourth round. Went 59.03, sits in the bronze medal position. Can she go further? Well, it's the first throw over 60 meters, so she looked good on the 59 meter throw. Keeps that point well under control, throws right through the point over the top, and that's the first recorded 60 meter throw, and she's happy with that. Clench of the fists, well done. Levita moves into gold medal position. So the Japanese Haruka Kitaguchi will go next. She's a 64 meter thrower. So 60 meters 15 on her fifth round attempt, and she looked as though she was warming up. Now we get to the interesting end of the competition, because we have Toksov of Turkey, who was fifth in the World Championships. Here she goes, sixth and final attempt. Well, the point stayed there for a little longer this time, but she's gone underneath it, and no real flight. Chirby desperately disappointed, steps out. She knows that throw isn't going to get her anywhere nearer than she is currently up the board. There's no pressure now. She's won the gold medal. Jasso Naita has got the gold, but this is her sixth round throw. She's thrown through the point again, just short. She dissects the 50 and 60 meter line. And now we see the celebration. Gold medal for the Lithuanian. She got this gold medal by stealth. She stalked them until the fourth round, moved into silver, and then in the fifth round, she threw 60 meters 36, and she takes gold for Lithuania. So here we go, a summary of the women's javelin result. So Jasso Naita of Lithuania takes gold, Kitaguchi takes silver, and Toksov of Turkey takes bronze.